Okay. So, I am here and I am back. Welcome back to my motherfucking channel, Lilith versus Eve, where the thing to be is free, okay? Free to say whatever the fuck you want to say, free to do whatever the fuck you want to do, and all that other shit with you bitches, really, which I'm not going to say you bitches because, you know, it's not a lot of you. But a lot of people don't understand and get that in their head what my channel really is about, you know? They don't understand when I say free to do whatever the fuck you want. That's what I meant. And I'm going to try not to cuss because I got a real legit cussing problem. So, the title, you can tell by the title of this video, it's not going to be a controversial video, but I mean, it's going to be a little something, something. So, what these mentors are not explaining, because this girl really fixed her fingers, to come under my page and say, one, that she feel like I need help with my persona, and she feel like I need help with my look, okay? So, what these mentors are not going to tell you, because, of course, they want your money, and, of course, everybody feels like they know it all. You don't have to have a certain look, baby. You do not have to have a certain look to get a sponsor, to get a man with money, to live above your means. That is what society is telling you. A woman that looks like this, a woman that does this, a woman that talks like this, that's going to be the woman that's going to get a guy. So it is always important to think about the type of guy that you want and then attract to that type of guy. I mean, and then think about the type of guy, the type of woman that guy would date. That is definitely important. But then you also have to think about this. There are multiple millionaires out there, okay? There are multiple millionaires. You got the high-class ones, and then you got the low-class ones that maybe just came up with some money or that don't give a fuck about the looks. What matters, baby, is your energy, okay? You can talk, you can be straight from the hood, and you can find you a white nigga that got some bread and goddamn, see my shit fucking up. You can find you a white guy that got some bread and come up. It doesn't matter. What matters is the energy and why people say do your makeup, why people say dress a certain way. I mean, yeah, you don't want to be dressing matters. That's one thing that matters. But you don't got to be like name brand, you know, just look nice. But why people say to do all these things is because it puts you on that frequency. It does something to your brain that makes you feel like, okay, now I feel good, now I feel worthy, and now I can go out and I can get that man. It puts you on that high frequency. You don't have to change according to what someone else says. Like, why would I go to that girl? Why would I pay this girl money for her to tell me how to be myself? Like, no. Why would I put, once I heal, when you heal yourself and you get it through your head that you deserve a better guy in your life, that you deserve a guy that's going to spoil you, when you deserve a guy that's going to give you money, when you get that shit in your head, baby, and you really truly believe that and you really truly feel that shit in your fucking mind, body, and soul, that man is going to come. That's just how the universe works. You don't need a mentor. You don't need someone to tell you how to be your fucking self. You don't need someone to tell you how to dress. You don't need someone to tell you how to fucking act. That shit is bogus, and that shit is bullshit, and that shit is for the fucking bitches that can't get their goddamn mind right. It's some people that need somebody to do that because they just been beat down their whole entire fucking lives, and they just can't get it in their head how to do the shit. They just can't get it in their head how to be their fucking selves. And that's not, you know, whatever. If that's what you need, then do that. But the main part is to fix yourself. You can fix your hair all you fucking want. You can fix your attitude, not your attitude. You can fix your hair all you want. You can fix, put on some red lipstick. You know, do all that extra shit. But if you're not giving off that energy, if you're not beating on that fucking frequency, then that man is still not going to come. And a lot of people, you need you be needing people to tell you, like, do this, do that, and help get you on that fucking frequency. But when that person leaves, that's just like a man. Women, some women get men in their life and they start thriving. They want to do their hair again. They want to do this and do that. But as soon as when that man leaves, baby, you don't have enough agility, endurance, or whatever, or self-worth to keep yourself fucking going. So when y'all read comments like that under my fucking page, ignore it. It screams insecurity. It screams lack of knowledge. It screams a lot lack of fucking self-worth too, because you need someone else to tell you how to do how to live, how to, you know, how to do your fucking own thing. Like, boo, go sis. It's like, it's no, just keep it, boo. Just fucking keep it. And another fucking thing. If you have a problem, which I don't understand why you would have a problem with me sharing my location, as if we have dual locations, as if someone, me sharing my location, someone's automatically gonna get your location. I don't understand people who don't know how to shut the fuck up, mind their fucking business, and let the universe handle what the fuck they need to handle, okay? Look at my page. This lady talking about God. I don't believe in no, I mean, I believe in fucking God, but I don't believe in no goddamn Jesus God. I don't believe in the fucking Bible. I believe there are lessons to be learned in the fucking Bible, but I don't believe in how Christians believe in it, and I'm far from fucking Christian, boo. I'm like on the opposite end of the fucking scale, y'all can tell you that, okay? So with that being said, if I share my location, if I share how much money I have, mind your business. If you feel some type of way, just say it in your head and keep it pushing, boo. There's no reason for you to embody that fucking energy, that negative as. It's no need for it. Just let it go, boo. Hold on real quick. Like, don't stop embodying that energy. Just let it go. And the other girl gonna comment that I'm green. Okay, well, try it then. Please try it, baby. Try it. I'm far from green, bitch. Red, stop. Stop. Red, stop. No, try it, please. Okay? Y'all motherfuckers is off the chain. And I already know that it's going to just be more and more and more. And I'm not going to have the time to respond to every single one of you guys. But that has a negative comment to say, because as my channel grows, and baby, it will grow. Now that's what's green, okay? Now that's what's green. And and I'm gonna have a bunch of followers. I'm gonna have a bunch of videos. Mark my fucking words, because like I said, I am protected and guided by the Most High. And I don't mean the Bible, because that ain't the Most High, boo boo. I meant larger than that. And another thing, like, I'm just giving the information that I know, okay? I'm just giving the information that I have experienced and all of that things, and all the things, like, there's multiple different type of rich men. There's not just the rich man in the fucking suits, okay? You can find a rich man at the fucking T-Mobile store. I see T-Mobile. You can find a rich man at the fucking, the ghetto-ass corner store. Like, there's rich men everywhere. And you're not going to understand that until you put yourself in that fucking frequency. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how you look. And that's what I'm saying. Like, y'all be, like, they be trying to make people seem insecure. And I'm not going to say they, as in, like, these mentors or anything like that. But I feel like they don't tell you guys that you don't have to match that. You don't have to match everyone else. You don't. You have to stand out some type of fucking way. You have to. Even if it's your dominant. Just be yourself, okay? Be yourself. Know your worth. This is how easy it is to get a fucking sugar daddy. Be yourself, know your worth, know that you deserve a guy with money. You don't have to have straight hair, you don't have to have blonde hair, you don't have to have blue eyes, you don't have to have a small stomach with abs or nothing. Do what makes you feel right. But long as you know what you deserve and you stick to it, long as you have your agreements and you stick to your agreements, baby, them sugar daddies is gonna come. They're going to come. You might need little minor fucking adjustments here and there, but still at the time, the universe works in mysterious ass ways. I'm telling you, you can goddamn don't ever go out, but you every night you write, you saying your mantras, you writing down in your journal, you doing the work that you need to get yourself on that frequency, and next thing you know, you can go out and have a flat tire, the guy can pull up and it can be your next fucking sugar daddy. Like, people don't think like that. Some things take time, and a lot of people, we're in the world where people want things fast, so they like, oh my god, I'm not getting a sugar daddy. They try for, you know, a couple days, try to go out, they're not getting a sugar daddy, so they're like, oh, let me go pay for a mentor. Yeah, like, just like Nikola Tesla said, if you want to know the secrets of the universe, think in terms of frequency, energy, and I forgot the other one he said, but that is facts. Like, you don't need all of this special shit. And though, you know, all these mentors are going to do, it's a psychological game, okay? It's a fucking psychological game. All in the end of the day, what they do, which they probably don't even know that they're doing it either, or neither, whatever, is all they're doing is putting you on that frequency. You can get on that frequency by yourself, baby. Learn by yourself. That's when it's more valuable, when you learn by yourself and you actually go out there and you invest in the books and all of this and all of that shit. You learn about personalities, you learn about the zodiac signs, you learn about how people work, maneuver, 48 laws of power, the art of seduction and all that shit. Then you get to where you need to be. Hold on, guys. I'm gotta get my filter change. Okay, I'm still getting my filter change, but I'm gonna leave you guys with this message: is money is a frequency. Okay, repeat that, and until it's literally embedded in your head. Money is a frequency. Money is a frequency. When you're beating on that frequency, money is always going to come. Money is always going to come. And that's just period. Like, there's no science to it. There's no science to getting a sugar daddy. No science to none of that shit. It's all frequency. That's what you gotta put in your head. That's what these mentors are not gonna tell you, that it's a frequency. It is a frequency. Period. And when they're having bad days, it's because they're not beating on that frequency. And you know, I don't have to worry about money, because sometimes I forget that money is a frequency, and I think it's something that you got to go out there and get, but that's not true.
We told today we'll bring you the with the $5 off discount, we'll bring you the $19.29. Did you need a water before you leave?
No, it's fine. Thank you.
What'd you get for Chick-fil-A?
Just some fries and a coffee.
I just got that stuff.
I don't even drink coffee, but I'm like, I need some coffee.
I can't stand coffee. Oh my god. I only had that like 3 times in my life. You have any trash you throw away?
No, I'm fine. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm going to see that.
You too. Have a nice day at work. Thanks. I'm a hot. Okay, so yeah. And one thing you cannot do is let these and let these bitches lower your fucking frequency, okay? Don't let these bitches lower your fucking frequency, especially if you do YouTube videos, especially if you're sharing your sugar baby experience and all that stuff. Don't let these bitches lower your fucking frequency just because they ain't fucking secure. Because whenever I read a bitch comment anything, I'm like, you're insecure. Whenever I read a bitch comment, don't do this, don't do that, because somebody might do this, you're walking in fear. And what is fear? False evidence appearing real, okay? Period. Just like with this World War III shit. I don't want to get off topic, but y'all gonna have to understand that this is not just a sugar baby channel. This is a spiritual channel also. Like, this is not a, it's not a witchy channel, none of that shit, because I don't call myself a witch no more, bitch. I'm an alchemist. I'm an alchemist. And there's that. But I'm on, if you see me slack off on the sugar baby videos or the freestyle videos, it's just because I'm on a spiritual journey. Like, I'm on a real spiritual journey. I'm not just out here looking for money. Actually, I don't look for money. One thing I won't say anymore, and I said that shit yesterday, is I'm chasing the bag. I don't chase the bag. I do not chase the bag, okay? The bag chases me, and that's just period. I am the bag, and that's facts, because you think about it, chase the bag. Like, why are you out here chasing money? You shouldn't have to chase money. Put yourself in that fucking frequency, and money's going to come, and that's just the fucking beauty of it. That's just how shit works. I didn't make this shit up, okay? The universe did. This is how we were fucking born. So, yeah, that's really my TED talk for today. I feel like I had one more thing to say though. I don't think I should put this cream in my coffee, because doesn't cream have milk in it? I shouldn't be eating these french fries either. Everything is frequency. Once you on that frequency, everything's gonna come. Oh yeah, I don't just do sugar baby shit. Like, I do that shit when I can. Huh, he's smiling at me. I do that shit when I can, because I have a online, like, I do online shit. As far as how I make money, I do online shit. I got OnlyFans, I got clip sites. Man, excuse me. Yeah, is that how I make my money? I'm like, geez. I used to do cam girling, but I don't do that shit anymore. Shit too difficult. But yeah, like, so I don't be focusing on being a sugar baby or freestyling 24/7, because a lot of times, because I make money online, I will go out and freestyle and I won't be successful, because I'll be like, fuck this shit. And then I'll be trying to drink, which I have to drink in order to get me in the mood to, you know, talk to a whole bunch of different personalities. Not all the time though, because I have went out and drunk without, I mean, and didn't drink and talk to people, but I don't have, freestyling is a full-time job. It really is. Like, freestyling is a full-time job, so a lot of times I don't feel like investing myself in that, but then I still make money. Like, I meet guys offline, so it always works out. And don't judge me by how I act on here and think that I act this way towards guys, because that is false, okay? That is false. I don't, like, a guy can find my fucking YouTube, he'd be like, wow, like, you totally deceived me. Because I don't do all of that shit. And the thing, and the different things about me is, I can show you my book collection. Like, I'm actually invested in this shit. And it's not just because of the sugar daddies and all that shit, but I like to learn how people work. I like to learn how people embody their emotions and all of that deep shit. I like to know how the brain work. I'm really heavy on astral traveling. I'm really heavy on becoming one with the universe, LSD, shrooms, learning about yourself, the brain, and how shit works, learning about what's going to happen as we die, you know, learning about the spiritual world, spiritual realm, different dimensions and all that shit. A lot of you bitches don't be on that shit, and y'all be coming here trying to goddamn project your low vibrating ass comments, and it's like, shut the fuck up. Like, I'm on some totally different shit, and that's why it's always best to just shut the fuck up. It's always best to just shut the fuck up. I preach this shit on Facebook all the time. I'm like, listen, before you leave that comment under somebody's shit, go start you a fucking YouTube channel. Go start you a blog. Go start you a podcast. Go start you something, a book or something, so you can just write all that fucking information down and you can give it to the bitches that care, okay? The bitches that care can buy the shit. And you can make money off of it, okay? Instead of leaving the fucking comments, and we understand it's the internet, people can leave comments, whatever, whatever. But, I mean, like, why? Not why leave comments, but why do something that don't benefit you? You know what I'm saying? Why? I say this shit all the time. Before you go and comment under my shit, it's best, if you don't want to get your ass cussed out, it is best you just go start your own fucking channel. Your own fucking blog, your own fucking podcast. You will get further, okay? And then you can reach out to the bitches that actually give a fuck about what you gotta say, instead of me, who don't give a fuck, okay? And who will eventually delete your comment because I'm gonna be tired of seeing it. And now you just wasted some time in your fucking life, and that's that. So yeah, thank you for coming to my channel. Like always, like, comment, subscribe, click that bell button, ding, so you can get updates of when I do post some other rants. And thank you for coming to my, thank you for coming to my TED Talk. This bill, nope. Peace. Okay, I actually thought I was done, but I'm not. One thing I was gonna say about the fear part is that, you know, you bitches done been through so much or saw some other shit went down and maybe another whole life that y'all feel like it's gonna happen to everybody. But no, not everybody is beacon on such a low frequency as you or these other fucking women. Some women, some people know how to trust their intuition. Some people know how to develop their psychic ability to the point where they will never be put in a situation that could harm them, okay? So if I ever get robbed, which I don't plan on getting robbed, nobody plans on getting robbed, but I have this voice in my head that tells me when a situation can go left, and I listen to that voice. And that's another thing. Learn how to trust yourself, and you will never find yourself in a situation like that. Everybody that's been in a situation like that, they always say, like, yeah, I just had this feeling, but they don't trust that feeling. Learn how to trust yourself, and you will never find yourself in a situation like that. You will never find yourself in danger. You will never find yourself in fear. You will never find yourself moving weird. Like, no. I listen to myself. I say my mantras, and I meditate every day. Excuse me, guys. I had to fart. Oh, my God. Was it them French fries? Oh, God. Oh, it stinks. That was nasty. I shouldn't have put that in a YouTube video, but I did, okay? I did, and it's okay. But, because we're all human here. But, yeah, like, you have to trust yourself. And it, oh, they got a little tiny house. I never noticed that before. It took me a while to learn how to trust myself. And even then, like, my emotion goes up and down. Like, some days I trust myself and some days I fucking don't. But when it comes to fucking with these niggas, Oh, bitch, I trust myself. I always listen to that gut feeling. Always. And never have I ever been put in a situation where, you know, where I've ever got robbed, ever got raped, or anything like that. Or I've had sex with someone and they didn't take me. Like, always dot your I's and cross your T's and all of this shit. So, and that's my last little 2 cents. I don't know how y'all gonna like that part, but that's just facts. Like, that's just facts. Develop yourself first and foremost. Before you go out here trying to get a sugar daddy and all of that, because that's why bitches be getting caught up with these niggas with money, and the next thing you know, the niggas move on to something different, and you feel broken, you feel less than, you feel all of this because you didn't do the work first on yourself. So, and that's that. That's my 2 cents. So, yeah. I won't go through the whole outro again, but see you guys in the next video.